Greetings, Shelby County Schools family. Last week, I spoke to you about grace. And with grace, you ultimately learn the essence of gratitude. In this moment, I'm grateful to have heard so many of you continue to speak life to this situation and uplift Shelby County Schools like never before. And I just want to say thank you. The coronavirus pandemic has completely changed the way we all see the world. We are living in the most challenging times of our lives, and this district, our teachers, community leaders, and each of you, essential workers, husbands, fathers, mothers, and grandparents, need grace above all things. As you've likely heard, there's been a forceful call this week from our nation's top leadership to reopen schools for all children in the fall. While I know that educating our children and reopening schools are top of mind for all families, I will not be pressured to put students or staff in harm's way. The F in our SAFE plan for reentry stands for flexibility. The COVID-19 numbers are steadily rising in many regions of the country, and we are seeing our highest cases yet, right here in Shelby County. As this pandemic is rapidly changing day to day, we must be flexible. And I ask that our principals, teachers, students, and parents also be flexible as we work to do what's best for children. We released our reentry plans this week, and we're asking parents to make a commitment about in-person or virtual instruction, not as a restriction, but rather to help us plan for staffing, adjust class sizes, to better prepare for how we educate students in this new normal. Now here's Jerrica with more about the release of our reentry plan and this week's updates.
Nearly 20,000 families have already selected a student learning option for the fall semester this week. The process opened on July 6th, allowing families to select fully in-school or fully virtual learning for the upcoming fall semester. We've been able to answer many questions from families this week, and you can find those answers to help make an informed choice at scsk12.org/learning options. The period to select a learning option ends July 18th. If a choice is not made, students will be automatically enrolled in the in-school option. On Monday, July 13th, we'll be holding a virtual community conversation to give families, educators, and the community a more in-depth understanding of our SAFE reentry plan. Members of the SCS leadership team will be explaining key sections of the plan during the live broadcast and addressing frequently asked questions. Join us at 6 p.m. on the SCS Facebook and Twitter pages, voiceofscs.com and C19, to hear how we're working to return stronger this fall. The Department of Exceptional Children is launching a new hotline next week to assist families of students who receive special education and CLU services. Parents can call 901-416-5206 Monday, July 13th through Friday, July 17th to get answers about how their child's specific individualized education plans or IEPs will be supported through the two learning options this fall. The hotline will be available each day from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. This week, we announced plans for our Class of 2020 virtual graduation, which will take place Saturday, July 18th at 5 p.m. This is the final phase of our three-part celebration for 2020 graduates. Although we were hopeful that conditions would improve enough to allow in-person ceremonies in July, as originally planned, this is the safest way to celebrate our graduates, given the steady rise in COVID-19 cases in Shelby County. We're planning to make this an unforgettable evening with a variety of broadcast options to allow family and friends from around the country to easily tune in and be a part of this special occasion together. Stan Bell will be hosting the address with remarks from Superintendent Ray and our school board, and some surprise celebrity guests. During the live broadcast, families will be directed to each school's virtual graduation ceremony. The ceremonies will also be archived for future viewing at scsk12.org /class of 2020. We've added more school-based summer meal sites to serve bulk breakfast and lunch packs every Wednesday in July. We now have 11 SES school sites providing the 6-day meal packs. Plus, the YMCA is still serving single-day meals every day at dozens of sites across Shelby County every Monday through Friday this summer. Click the summer meals link at scesk12.org/coronavirus facts for an updated list of meal sites every week.
Thanks, Jerrica. As she mentioned, we look forward to walking families through our safe reentry plan and answering more questions during our virtual town hall next week. Throughout the past 4 months, I have been exceedingly grateful for the wise counsel and the invaluable input from members of the Shelby County Board of Education. We also value principal, teacher, student, and stakeholder input, which is why, in addition to our reentry task force, we held listening sessions, hosted educator focus groups, sat down with teacher association leaders and our student congress. And you probably have filled out more surveys than you would care to receive, but we appreciate your solution-based feedback. Speaking of feedback, as you've heard me say, there will always be those who criticize, but doing nothing is not an option. Some choose to publish demands, post divisive comments online, and use sound bites in the news to sow discord, but we will continue to commission all who are willing to join us as change champions for Shelby County Schools and the entire 901 community. We are stronger together. Coronavirus will not defeat us. We are 901.